Good morning. I'm Pastor Doug Tomhave. I serve here as one of the pastors at St. Paul's Lutheran Church in Lake Mills, Wisconsin. It's a privilege to be with you this morning to share some devotional thoughts. And let's make our beginning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, as a pastor, I've been asked this question based on what we've been going through for quite some time now. Is the end of the world coming soon? And to that I can say, sure, yeah. Do I mean that it's coming today or tomorrow? I don't know. Only God himself knows. But Jesus did give us some predictions. This is before it was Holy Week or Easter Sunday. Jesus told, before he was even betrayed by Judas, Jesus gave us these words to talk about the days that would come when he, before he would return. In Luke chapter 21, let's look at verses 25 to 28. There will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. On the earth, nations will be in anguish and perplexity at the roaring and tossing of the sea. Men will faint from terror, apprehensive of what is coming to the, on the world, for the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time, they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to take place, stand up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. Well, what is it that's getting people to ask these questions? We have a tanking economy. We have oil prices that are at zero. I've never seen prices for filling up your tank like this. We have this virus that has pretty much brought to a standstill a roaring economy throughout the world. We have nations that have closed down an airline industry that is pretty much at a stop. We have scientists frantically trying to get ahead of this to figure out how we're going to stop the coronavirus. And at the same time, we have storms that still come. And we have hurricanes that are still developing. We have a death toll that is on the rise. And all these things make us stand in our homes and stand up and pay attention and wondering, is the Lord returning soon? Well, let me tell you, according to these words, first, this reality. Jesus wants us to know and to be sure that all these things, as we know them, are going to come to an end. And so this is a sobering reality check for us too, as we get so busy in lives, we think this is all there is. We're so absorbed in it. Jesus says all that is that you know on earth will come to an end, including you. And there'll be signs, there'll be pains that have happened as nations and individuals undergo suffering. And you'll see things in creation that are in the sky or around us, natural catastrophes. And so it is ever getting closer. And then we hear what's going to happen. The Son of Man is going to come. And that's a scary thing if you think of God coming to judge the whole planet. But for us who live in the resurrection, for us who know Jesus is, this is actually a good thing. Did you catch the tail end there? This is a time we should stand up and rejoice when these things are happening around us to the planet and get us fearful of, is this going to continue on? We can stand with Jesus and his words and say, this is good news. Because when these things happen and these things come, we know Jesus is closer to returning. And as the passage ends here, it says, your redemption is drawing near. That is such good news for us, because we understand now why Jesus came to do what he did. He came to destroy everything that sin brings, that destroyed creation, that destroyed us. And so he took it to the cross and God accepted that sacrifice. All sin paid for. And sin's consequence is death, and everything is slowly dying, you, me, the planet around us. But then Jesus went and experienced real death, separation from God, judgment under him in our place, and then the tomb was empty, which means that Jesus took back all his power to show us he has power over death, all death, our death. And now he uses all that power to rule and to reign over all things. As much as this is impacting us as far as God and his kingdom, there is no impact. Jesus' plan is still intact, and he's coming back for you and for me. So what do we do in the midst of all this suffering and unknowns and worry and sleepless nights and safer at home and wondering what next is going to come with the economy and everything? Well, we do know that the Lord is closer to his return. And when we see these things around us, we can follow Jesus' words, and he says to take heart, to stand up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing you near. Jesus is going to return for you, for me, that all that know him. And that is something that we can bank on, because Jesus keeps his promises. May God bless you, whatever you're going through, with the hope and truth that Jesus is your Savior and that you are truly saved. Let's close with this prayer. Dearest Lord, thank you for your words before you left this earth, reminding us that this earth is broken and it is coming to an end. But as this earth comes to an end, Lord, that means that you are returning and you're going to end all the things that are wrong and replace it with all the things that are perfect and true, including us and the creation around us. You call it heaven, and it will be perfect and it will be forever. Help us to lift our heads and to stand tall, because our redemption is drawing near, the redemption that was made possible by you. It's in your name we boldly pray. Amen. And until we meet again, I put the Lord's blessing upon you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you peace. Amen.